As the so-called war on drugs enters its fifth decade, we need to ask whether it and the approaches that comprise it have been truly effective and build on the administration's efforts led by the Office of National Drug Control Policy to usher in a new approach. And with an outsized, unnecessarily large prison population, we need to ensure that incarceration is used to punish, to deter, and to rehabilitate, but not merely to warehouse and to forget. Today, a vicious cycle of poverty, criminality, and incarceration traps too many Americans and weakens too many communities. And many aspects of our criminal justice system may actually exacerbate these problems rather than alleviate them. We also must confront the reality that once they're in that system, people of color often face harsher punishments than their peers. One deeply troubling report, released in February of this year, indicates that in recent years, black male offenders have received sentences nearly 20% longer than those imposed on white males convicted of similar crimes. This isn't just unacceptable, it is shameful. It is unworthy of our great country. It is unworthy of our great legal tradition. And in response, I have today directed a group of U.S. attorneys to examine sentencing disparities and to develop recommendations on how we can address them. We will start by fundamentally rethinking the notion of mandatory minimum sentences for drug-related crimes. Some statutes that mandate inflexible sentences, and this is regardless of the individual conduct that is at issue in a particular case, reduce the discretion available to prosecutors, judges, and to juries. Because they oftentimes generate unfairly long sentences, they breed disrespect for the system. When applied indiscriminately, they do not serve public safety. They, and let's be honest, some of the enforcement priorities that we have set have had a destabilizing effect on particular communities, largely poor and of color. And applied inappropriately, they are ultimately counterproductive. This is why I have today mandated a modification of the Justice Department's charging policy so that certain low-level, nonviolent drug offenders who have no ties to large-scale organizations, gangs, or cartels will no longer be charged with offenses that impose draconian mandatory minimum sentences. They now will be charged with offenses for which the accompanying sentences are better suited to their individual conduct rather than excessive prison terms more appropriate for violent criminals or drug kingpins. By reserving the most severe penalties for serious, high-level, or violent drug traffickers, we can better promote public safety, deterrence, and rehabilitation while making our expenditures smarter and more productive.